So this program here will count the number of instances of a particular letter in a list. So in other words, we could type in the letter A and it would count up how many times A appears in our list here. So just as a quick reminder on how lists work, the first entry in a list is 0, the second one is 1, third one is 2, and so on. And these are called index numbers. So the index number of predator is 1. Now, I've set up a counter here to keep count of the amount of times that a letter appears. And we've got an input statement which will ask the user to type in the letter they would like to see how many times it appears. Now, we set up a loop here. And this goes from 0, index number 0, which is aliens, to the end of the list, which is Star Wars Episode 3. So it will run and it will look at all of these. Now, we've got a second list here. So what this does here is we start at 0, position 0, and it picks out the first movie in the list. Okay, so X starts at 0, the counter starts at 0, okay, and that will increase every time the loop goes by 1, but the first time it runs is 0. So what is at movies, which is the list name, and position 0? That is aliens. Okay, so it will look in there, and if the letter the user types in, let's say for example they type in A, if it matches this statement here, and what this means is movies, which is our list, X, which is the first entry in the list, which is aliens, and Y, which is the first letter in the word aliens, okay, if it matches, it'll add 1 to the counter. Okay, so because A is in there, the counter will go up by 1. Now, this internal loop here will end once it gets to the end of aliens. There's no more A's, so this now ends. And it goes back to this loop, the outer loop, and X now becomes 1. So this time, it looks at predator. Okay, so if we change all of these, and just to explain how this works, sorry, that will start off at 0 because we haven't looped that one yet. Okay, so what this is now doing, this is looking at movies, X, X is now 1, so it's looking at movies and whatever is in index position 1, which is predator. And down here, we're saying if letter is equal to movies X, which is predator, and then the first item in predator, which is P. So is A equal to P? No. So it won't add 1 to the counter. Now, this loop will now go up by 1 because we haven't found an A. So we now look at the first index of the list, which is predator, and then the first index number, which is R. Is it an A? No. So same thing happens. Loop goes up again. And it looks at the next letter along, which is E. Still no joy. Okay, so it will keep going up until it finds the letter A. And we do have one, which is at position 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then it'll add another 1 to the counter. So all you have to remember, really, is the X and Y value will increase by 1 each time. And you can match up what's going on here with the index numbers to the first bracket being the actual word, okay, and the second bracket being the character within the word. Okay, now let's just run this and see how it works. So we'll search for A, as that was our example. A, press enter, and it's found 6 A's in our list. Okay, so we could count up there and we would find 6 A's. So that is essentially how our nested loop works.